our Seaside band. Woohoo! Hello, welcome. I invite you to come on in from the social hall or take a chair in the social hall if that feels better to you. We're getting ready to start service. Hello, it's good to see you here this morning. Hello, hello, hello. Hi, I'm Reverend Debbie McDonald. It's my joy to be here with you this morning. We are changing things up a little bit. We are going to encourage you to check out our website. If you want to know what's happening at Seaside, the place to go is seasidecenter.org. Click on the What's Happening tab on the left side, and it will take you to everything that is happening here. So if you want to know what's going on, please remember to go to the website. Go to the website and find out what's happening. Also, you can sign up for what we call our swag, Seaside Week at a Glance, and that will be delivered straight to your inbox every Friday morning, and you'll know what's going on for the week. You'll know what the talk title is, you'll know who the musicians are gonna be, you'll know what classes are starting, you'll know what events are happening. So continue to use those tools that we've created for you. And That's where we're going with announcements moving forward. Encourage you to do that. If there's something really big coming up, we'll let you know. But we encourage you to check out the website. But what I'd like to ask you to do now is to please stand and greet your neighbor, and please remain standing for the congregational song.
For our congregational song. We know this one. It's been a while since we've done it. I want you to sing along with us. Yes. Put your hands together.
Woo! Whoa.
Me.
Hey, you feel that? The Spirit of God upon you? Woo! Well, good morning, Seaside. What a joy it is to be with all of you here, with all of you that are with us virtually. The Spirit of God is upon us, and this music is just getting going, huh?
It's awesome.
It's awesome. And there's a lot of music today.
You know, I'm not going to argue about
yeah,
that.
Yeah, yeah.
I love it.
Hey, I see one of your singers today, Whitney, has got a full page in the Union.
Look at that.
Get that on camera. Whitney, congratulations. We're so proud of you. I know Rebecca had us voting for you, as well as Carissa and Rebecca for best performers here in San Diego. All of you are up for different categories. So
thank you to everybody who voted and for Seaside supporting us. We really, really appreciate it.
Yep, that's good. Hey, I want to remind everybody who's at home, and even if you're here, pull out your phone, tune in, get your friends to get on board with what's happening today, because today it is energy Stevie Wonder packed kind of morning.
Woo, and you can feel
that energy going around here.
Yes,
I mean, start early in the week. You know, I do my quiet, you know, composed daily meditation. And I got hacked on Friday. So, I mean, if anybody knows how I can undo this, please, please tell me. But Marv, you want to show everybody what happened to me?
Hello, Christian here. Hey, do I have a hat and glasses on for you? Oh, my goodness.
I had no idea.
It's like I got to go with what I've got with my... What's on my video? I don't have that kind of knowledge to get rid of it. So, I mean, it's pretty funny what I'm looking at. So I'm wearing a hat and glasses. Oh, just figure I'm cool today and I'll have somebody figure out how to get them off. But if people are tuning in later, oh man, I don't know if you're seeing what I'm seeing, but it's pretty bizarre from my perspective. Anyway, Christian here, and I got the hat, man, that's funny. Okay, I'm going to get centered. I don't know how you can stay centered looking at what I'm looking at. But if you do, good job.
Let's round that up. That's enough. Yeah. I was hijacked by Stevie Wonder. Man, I got my shades on. Yeah, that's good.
Well, you're always cool, so don't worry about
that.
That's
just
anything. But you're always cool in our book, right?
Yeah, that's good. That's right. But anyway, hey, you know, the views that day doubled.
Well, see.
That's crazy.
Keep away from the cat face.
Okay, I'll do that one. Okay, that's good. Hey, I'll tell you what, let's get rolling here. We have got a wonderful practitioner who's really going to cast the consciousness for us. Maggie, one of our newest licensed practitioners at Seaside. Why don't you take us there?
Nothing like a little humor to center us in our hearts. I would like to have our light holder meet me in the middle, as we shine a light. Now I will sound the bowl, and we can enjoy the vibration of all that is. We'll center our breath in the stillness, and then I will bring us into the room. I know that God is the one life. God is all there is, moving in, through, and as all that I see, all that I know, all that I feel. God is the power of the sun's rays on my skin. God is the peace in the brilliant moonshine. God is the ever-flowing waves on the shore. God is the love of humanity in the touch of a hug. I know that I express as God here now. I feel the vibration in my cells of the power, the peace, the flow, and the love. And I know that everyone here is that expression, the vibrant rhythm of life, longing to live and celebrate this day now. And so we are lifted to that higher ground by the words spoken by Reverend Christian, by the grace that we are held in by all who serve today, and by the exciting, vibrant, and joyous sounds of the music. And so today, I celebrate the rhythm of life.
Rebecca. Be still and know that we are God. It's so beautiful. We are so blessed with the musicians that we have, our band. I know. I said first service, it's the best ticket in town, you know, a summer concert series right here at Seaside. It's pretty darn good. Thank you for anchoring us so beautifully in prayer. And song, Maggie, thank you for your prayer. Carolyn, for holding the light, the high watch. Yes. You know, our practitioners are back in-house. Have you noticed? Yes. So please know our prayer chapel is open after service. For those of you online, the Zoom prayer room is still open as well. We have two ways for you to receive prayer. You can also send in a written prayer request to our prayer request chest or write it online. It's our practitioner's honor to pray with you. So please don't leave here with anything on your heart. Please know they are here for you. We have Caroline and Maggie and Cameron today here. So I want to welcome everyone, but I especially want to welcome anyone who's here for the first time or maybe returning back for the first time. Welcome. If you're new to Seaside, please know that we do have a first-time visitors package, we call it. It's in the basket where Cameron's standing back there by the Welcome Center. And you can just pick it up and take it with you. It's got daily Sights of Mind magazine. It's got a CD of Dr. Christian talking about the basic beliefs, and it has some few other things in there. So take it home, look over it, see if Seaside is a match for what it is that you're looking for. We hope that it is. But most importantly, stay afterwards. Have some coffee or tea or a muffin or a cookie and let us get to know you a little bit better. I want to share with you a little secret. Not so much a secret, but you're kind of the first to know about it. I want you to save the date. September the 19th. We're having an event here at Seaside. We're having one of those events that only Seaside can do. We're having a concert with Ray Davis after service. We're having lunch for everybody made by your board of trustees. We're calling it our 2030 event. We're going to cast a vision for 2030, which is, 9 years away. We are honoring that we've been in this building 20 years, which is crazy. But most importantly, and most especially, we are honoring Dr. Christian as our spiritual leader for 30 years. So put it on your calendar. Plan on being here. We love to have fun at Seaside. Yeah, so we will. Dr. Christian, as you heard, is going to be exploring and talking about the life of living legend Stevie Wonder today. And we have some wonderful, amazing music that's going to be going along with that. But I'd like to start out by doing a reading. And I am reading from a book called In the Flow of Life by Eric Butterworth. A little girl had a great fear of tunnels. Whenever she was riding on a train or in an automobile with her parents, she would hide her face and bury her head in her mother's lap when they went through a tunnel. As the years passed, she discovered that tunnels were not as fearsome as she had believed. Eventually, she remarked that she liked tunnels because they have light at both ends. This is a very significant thing to remember. In going through the dark tunnels of life, there is light at both ends. The thing that makes the difference in people and in the various circumstances they face is that some people let the tunnel experience become a static thing, bemoaning that there is no justice and this is the end, my life is over. Others, however, keep on keeping on, and they find growth and betterment as a result of these experiences. Physical handicaps have made cowards and weaklings of many people. Great heartaches and misfortunes have caused many to give up, to make their bed in the valley of misfortune, and ultimately to become bogged down in self-pity, bitterness, and disillusionment. But there are others, those like Beethoven, Stevenson, Milton, Steinmetz, and Helen Keller, who going through the dark tunnels of adversity have been spurred on to new achievement. The attitude in which the difficulty is met makes all the difference. If you are faced with a challenge, refuse to be panic-stricken. Life has not ended for you. Life flows on. Declare for yourself, I accept the reality of this situation, but not its permanence. Certainly, there is no point in hiding your head in the sand. The experience is there to be met. Determine that you will meet it, but on your terms. Do not let the outer happening squeeze you into its box, but open your mind to the flow of wisdom, love, and good judgment by which you can deal masterfully with it. Stand tall as you affirm, I meet this circumstance in complete confidence that he who is in me is greater than he who is in the world. I do not deny its reality, but I deny its permanence. I know that this too shall pass away. And so it is. God bless you. So glad you're here today.
That's a powerful reading. Thank you for that, Rep. Deb. Thank you so much. Wow. Yeah. Good morning, Seaside. Are we ready for some Stevie Wonder today? All right. I'm going to tell you, it was hard to pick some songs because his catalog is huge. Is that's perfect word for it. And he's got so many wonderful songs, and we kept on going back and forth about songs, and we decided on this one because it's just a great tune. It's a song called Sir Duke. We hope you like it.
Because the record has a groove, don't make it in the groove. You can tell right away a lesser A when the people start to move.
Come on!
They can feel it all over. They can feel it all over, people. They can feel it all over. They can feel it all over, people.
Come on!
Always will be one of the things that life just won't quit.
No.
But here are some of music's pioneers that time will not allow us to forget. No. Well, there's Betsy Miller, Satchel Moon, the king of all Sir Duke. With a voice like Ella's ringing out, there's no way the band can lose.
Woo!
You can feel it all over. You can feel it all over, people. You can feel it all over. You can feel it all over, people. You can feel it all over. Oh, you can feel it all over, people. You can feel it all over.
Oh,
is Rebecca Jade, Carissa Lynn, and Whitney Shay singing along with that Seaside band. My goodness, you guys are rocking it. Woo! Good going, Mike. So as Rebecca and I were talking about what are we going to do with Stevie Wonder, we came to recognize or absolutely realize this guy was about celebration. You know, he was about fun. You know, his music had one wanting to get up and dance. And John, who was at the first service, he's around here somewhere. Anyway, he just had a hip surgery last week or hip replacement. And he was up dancing with this little girl who said, I'm almost four. And it's like 84-year-old dancing with a four-year-old in our. And that's what Stevie Wonder does. There is a celebration that is just transcendent. It makes us feel young and excited inside. And so Rebecca and I, we talked and talked, and it's like, this was obvious. It doesn't matter what adversities were going on in Stevie's life. That was not what his music was about. It was about celebration of his life. And also this one, Sir Duke, was educational. I mean, you know, it came from the album Life in the Key of Music, which was, you know, it politicized funk. It had beautiful melodies. It had elegant ballads. And it had Sir Duke, which was educational, that, you know, taught the younger generation, you know, the shoulders this guy stood on. You know, Count Basie and Miller and Ella, the voice of Ella, and the king of them all, Sir Duke Ellington. And so, you know, Stevie, there we go. You know, he was just a genius, a musical genius, ahead of anyone else in that style of music in his era. He was a place that heard things that others couldn't hear. He went to a different place. You can feel it all over. You know, that's what the song was about. You could feel his music. He could paint the vibration of sunsets. He said, you know, music is a world within itself, a language all its own, an equal opportunity for all to sing and dance and clap their hands. And whether you were 4 or 84, it was going on here this morning. And so he was definitely a trendsetter. He was given a lot. You know, it's said that he who has been given a lot is expected. And Stevie delivered. He gave a lot. He continuously gave. And he said, you know what? I was blessed with these ideas. The genius in me is God expressing. You know, I am just God coming out. You know, God is coming out of me. It's like he gave it over to spirit, that this is the amazing thing. And so here's a guy who fused the different musical genres with a sense of celebration, bringing forth a new kind of sound that hadn't been heard. And he was brilliant. He was a kid, a prodigy. There's no question about that. And he said, you know, who I am, you know, the abilities I have, everyone has abilities. That everyone has abilities. The difference is what you do with them. And so Stevie, he wasn't born blind. He was born premature. And he was put in an incubator for a month, placed in the incubator that helped. And it was too oxygen rich. And what it did is it created his retinas to detach, and it's called retinopathy of prematurity. And it's when the retinas detach and one loses their sight. And when he came home, his sight was gone. But that didn't define who he was. Though, you know, when you lose a sense, you know, it's often said that other senses increase, and maybe his listening and hearing and feeling. But by the age of 11, he was recognized. He was signed by Berry Gordy at Motown, Tamil Records. And by the age of 12, he had produced his first single. By the age of 13, he had Billboard number one hit. Age of 13. You remember what you were doing at 13? You know, personally, I was playing ball in the park with my boys, you know, football, basketball, anything you could throw. You know, I was out there, or skateboarding, surfing, you know, touring the country, singing in front of people. It was not my jam, you know, but it was his. And he continued to bring forth the music and the wonder and the mastery. And the thing is, everybody loved Stevie Wonder. And it gave him the opportunity to push the social edges, you know, of his time. He used his music not just to entertain, but as it became more popular, he challenged the record company. I want more freedom. I want to be able to create. This album that we listened to, Life in the Key of Music, he did just about all of his own instrumentals. He did the drum, the bass, the guitar, the percussions, the keyboards. He sang. You know, they just don't make musicians like that anymore. He played at such a high level that there's nobody could match that, and he stepped into what his gift was. And so by the late 60s, he was taking on bringing his political stuff, uptight, everything's all right, he's putting out there, which, a lot of people couldn't do, but because of who he was and the popularity, he could begin to sing, once again, educating people with his politicized funk, his rock, his soul, his gospel. He would put out there, he'd sing Signed, Sealed, Delivered. Remember that one? I mean, this was in the 60s that came out. He sang, this is amazing for me to think about. Here's this kid. He's still in his teens. He's in school, and there's this this girl, and he creates a song for her, My Cherie Amour, the pretty, only pretty little one I adore, the only one my heart beats for. I wish you were mine. Take me. I mean, how does this come out of such a young spirit, like that? But he was a savant with the music. There was something about him that was powerful. And so if one stops to think about his evolution, his golden era was the 70s. And so, by the time he hit the 70s, so in 61, he was signed. He was 11 years old. So if you stop to think by 70, 71, he's only 21. And he's hitting his prime. He is hitting his golden era. He brings 10 years of traveling the globe, doing tributes to Ray Charles, winning Grammys, and he comes out with these monster hit albums, like three in a row. He did Inner Vision that had a song called Superstition. Superstition. We're going to do that one. It was like my favorite one. But, it's kind of spooky, it's kind of dark, if you believe in what you don't understand, you're sure for trouble, so we went with a different hit he had, and then it was called Higher Ground. It came from his Talking Book album, another Grammy winning. He went on to win 22 Grammys thus far, including an Academy Awards. And his whole thing is about celebration. Everybody loves Stevie Wonder. And, he didn't allow adversity to stop him. If there's challenges because of the social unrest or the racial challenges, he would sing about it. He would educate. He would use his instrument and his gifts and his talents to bring it to the world. He did not allow adversity of not being able to see to stop him, but he began to listen, to in that deeper place. And what was happening in that era, there was this new kind of sound coming out with the synthesizers. In the beginning of the 70s, the synthesizers were first coming onto the scene. People were experimenting with them. Well, not Stevie. He mastered it. He was using it. He was playing with it. Einstein said, creativity is God having fun. And that is Stevie Wonder, is God having fun. He mastered the synthesizer, which helped make the Inner Vision album a hit. He mastered it, and he brought forth, it was a fusion, really, of, he was a trailblazer that literally changed the ways in which, funk was done, rhythm and blues was done, gospel, soul, rock. There was something that he brought the electrification, if you would, to the music world and the album form, because he was the one who brought it to us. And so I was going to use Superstition because I love that sound. It's like one of my favorite. But the Higher Ground seemed to be a better choice because it came out at the end of 72 and beginning of 73. Stevie's driving home. He wasn't driving, but he was driving home from a gig, and there was an accident with a logging truck, and a log came through the windshield, shattered it, hit him in the head, and just wiped him out. I mean, he was, I won't say as good as dead, but he was in a coma. He was out. They didn't know whether he was going to live. He like hit that musician level where you have just taken on the world. You're at the top of it like Whitney, and out you go. He was at that place of choice. He was out for days. And in his room in a coma, a gospel singer by the name of Ira Tucker came in, and he belted out this song, Keep on Trying. until you reach higher ground. Keep on trying until you can reach higher ground. This song was trying again. It was like reincarnation. It's come back. Keep on loving. Keep on teaching. Keep on doing it again and again until you reach higher ground. And so Ira came in and he began to sing this song. And all of a sudden, for the first time, Stevie Wonder started tapping his fingers. And they noticed that it was going to the keyboard. And here's this little Wonder. When he was a little kid, they called him Stevie Wonder because he was wonderful and he was little. So it was little Stevie Wonder until he became 6 feet and started producing this monster music. And now this Wonder, Stevie Wonder, is out. And all of a sudden, his first movement is playing with his fingers, tapping it out. This gospel sounding. Take it to try, you know, keep on trying. Don't give up. You got that song for us? Let's lay that down. Let's hear. Man, you're stuck. Keep on trying. You know, you got to reach higher ground. What challenge do you have going on in your life? Are you in coma?
People, people, people need a higher ground. Yes, they do. People, people, people.
Rebecca Jade, Carissa Lynn, and Whitney Shay, along with the Seaside Band. Woo! People need a higher ground. It's just, that was so good. I called Rebecca. We talked that Friday afternoon. And said, Rebecca, you got to change. We got to play this song. What do you think? Right choice? Thank you for changing it up for us. And I did that to her on Thursday, too. Like she said, so much in the calendar. But could you imagine Stevie Wonder? You know, he's playing, you know, just a great, keyboard guy. And all of a sudden, you know, basically up into that time, you're playing one note at a time. And then all of a sudden, you find you now have a whole symphony at your fingertips to bring this sound, this vision, this feeling out that you are hearing inside of your head, the excitement to be that polyphonic expression of music that just changes the way music was played. Is that right, Max? Yeah, some more sound. There you go. That's Max, and he's playing not only the keys, but the synthesizer. You know, the thing about Stevie Wonder is that he just, you know, brings a sense of celebration in life. I mean, he's knocked out for days, and he comes back to Higher Ground, the song he created just before he went down. Who knew that that would have been the song that would bring him back out of coma? But when you're open, you're able to hear things. And so he had this affirmative approach to life. And Marv, you got this quote that seemed wonder. He said that, I'm always optimistic, but the world isn't. People need to make a jump to a place of positivity, but they put it all on one person to make it happen. It takes everybody. And the mindset has to be different. You know, our mindset has to be different that, you know, this one person isn't going to save me. You know, how many people are waiting for the Savior to return to save them? No wonder why it hasn't returned yet. There's just too much work to do for one person. But it takes all of us coming together to be that deliverer of that which turns us on, that gets us excited. You know, Rumi, the Persian poet, mystic, he said, you know, keep walking though you have no place to get to. You know, don't try to see through the distance. Take down your musical instrument and let what you see beautiful, that which you love, that the beauty you see, let that be what you do. That which you love and the beauty that you see, let that be what you do, because there are hundreds of ways to kneel and kiss the ground. So you don't stop. I got a hit. I'm quitting. I'm out of here. No. You got a project that hit the top. This is great. You just keep walking through. There is not an end. We're on a journey. We're just moving to higher ground. We're having an opportunity to do it again. And there's the Spirit wants to come through me. It's not one person and it's not a Savior that we're waiting for, but you are who we've been waiting for. How do you like that? Yeah, that's good. I actually stole it from Rompa when she was talking to Merv Griffin. He said, do you think somebody's going to save the world? And he said, yeah, you know, and who? He said, it's going to come through you. It's going to be you, Merv. He about fell out of his interviewing chair. Pretty big for going public with that stuff. Anyway, but, you know, I came across a rock sitting on my shelf that I give out to my class on the mountaintop. And it's interesting. I at the first class, I give people a rock. And I tell them to hold this rock, meditate on this rock, have this rock reveal yourself and, you know, itself to you. And what's interesting, after a few weeks, the people who do that, they come back and they've been holding this rock and they say, you know, I'm holding this rock and I can feel the whole mountain. I can hold this rock and feel and experience the whole mountain from which it came from. Some people come back and say, I can feel this rock when I'm sitting in the bottom of the ocean. That's the power that comes through one when you're willing to slow down and be available. You can hear music that other people don't have. Person's Rock, this was, gave it to me, had it put a quote on Ernest Holmes on here. It said that all the power of the universe
is in you. And that was Stevie Wonder's message to celebrate, is that we all got to reach that higher ground. We got to learn to celebrate. We got to not ration our passion. And he went full out on all of his songs. He played with such heart and such feeling. And it came from a place that you may have experienced. Those who wait upon the Lord, you know, are renewed, refreshed. They're lifted up on eagle's wings. You know, they will not tire. They will not fade. You know that saying. And that's as you wait, as you make yourself available, as you allow yourself to listen to what others don't listen, you become a conduit to bring it forth, because all the universe is seeking to express itself through you. And we all have ability, is what Stevie Wonder told us, right? Except it's the difference is how we use that. How are you using that in your life? How is it that you're bringing it forth? And what Stevie Wonder would do, I believe, and I think those who create things in life, is that they have the ability to wait open-endedly without having that expectation of what it is supposed to be. And when you begin to do that, to trust in the Spirit, you're moved beyond your imagining. When you're able to wait open-endedly and be available, you move beyond what you have imagined thus far, and you begin to be the place where Spirit is bringing forth a new sound, a new expression, a new level of heart, a new kind of vibration. This is what heals the body. This is what heals the relationship. This is what transforms the world, when we all can celebrate the gift and the magnificence of who we are and not apologize for whatever shortcomings we might have or any of the adversity in our life. It is fodder. It is food for me to bring into the celebration of life and not be stopped, because those who are able to listen beyond their imagining are exhibiting a wild and radical ability to be available for God to guide the way. And you begin to discover it is God's love that is directing your world rather than your fear. You know, because so often people take their anxiety, their fear, their headlines, whatever it is that's feeding that anxiety level, and focus on that. And it's not that things aren't going on in the world, but you notice how he wrote about them. You know, it's like they're going on, but I'm going to be open-ended and wait on the Spirit and be radically and amazingly available for that which is beyond my imagining, to bring forth a new sound that the world hasn't heard, that can be played on albums, that can be shared with the world, that my friends can say, man, this guy's crazy. He's seen the light. Something's wild going on. Because Stevie Wonder said, fear puts our dreams to sleep. Wow. Amen is right. You got any dreams sleeping? Well, what will wake them up is to fall in love again. And, you know, to feel that, to sense that, to share that. Stevie Wonder, I want to share with you, because he really left us a message of love. And he said that, do you know, it's kind of funny. And he didn't see my meditation. You know, he said, you know, it's funny, but I never thought of being blind as a disadvantage. And I never thought of being black as a disadvantage. I am what I am, and I love me. And I don't mean that egotistically. I love that God has allowed me to take whatever it was that I had and to make something out of it. All I ever wanted to do was music. And all I've ever asked, as I have gotten to know and discover the world more, is that God would use me in any way to encourage and to inspire, and to inspire people to bring and give love to each other. Yeah. And if you take a look at the catalog of his songs, its fattest section is love songs, like Love is in Need of Love Today. Remember that one? How about You Are the Sunshine of My Life? Or I Just Called to Say I Love You. How about She's So Lovely? You know he was singing about a baby on that one? Or a song, I Believe. You know, when I fall in love, it will be forever. Ah. Is that beautiful? Other ones, For Once in My Life. You know, I found someone to love me. You know, Anna. But the song that Rebecca and I felt we wanted to end with here today is done a little differently than when she did it for Easter. A couple years back. It is truly a love song. And some kind of think maybe this song was, you know, from the singer to his beloved. But then again, there's another interpretation that it is the beloved God, the Abrahamic God, or the, you know, the Western kind of God, that is singing its song through the singer. And then there's others who just feel it was Stevie Wonder's approach to move beyond individual love towards love of humanity, and it was song to the world. He it was said, you know, I will love you. I will always, you know, love you. And he, you know, he drew these pictures of things that were absolutely impossible to achieve, like, what was it, you know, until the rainbow burns out the stars, you know, until the oceans reach the mountain high, until dolphins fly and parrots live at the ocean, and I'll keep loving you always, even until, you know, this is it, until like palm trees or trees and oceans get up and fly away, or until you become me and I become you. I will be loving you always is his message in the love song that was his message for all of us.
Oh, hands around the sun, the earth knows she's revolving, and the rosebuds know to bloom in early May. Just as hay knows love's a cure, you can rest your mind assured that I'll be loving you always. As now can't reveal the mysteries of tomorrow, but a passing will grow older every day. Just as all is born is new, do you know what I say is true? Then I'll be loving you always.
Until the rainbow burns the stars out of the sky.
Always.
Thank you.
dolphin flies and parrots live at sea. Until we dream of light and light becomes a dream.
Always.
Until the day is night and night becomes the day. Until the trees and seas just up and fly away. Until the day that 8 times 8 times 8 is 4.
Rebecca Jade, Carissa Lynn, and Whitney Shay, and the Seaside Band, and my goodness, what music thing. I don't know how you guys do that every night. It's like, I worked out. Man, dancing, talking, singing, it's crazy. Well, what do you think of the music today? Pretty good, huh? Oh, man, that was definitely reminiscent of my days, you know, back in there. So this is the time of our service where we have the opportunity to share our love, to give our gift, and as you give, it comes back. You're the activity that God is having. Is God abundant? Is God having fun? Remember, Einstein said, you know, creativity, is God having fun? I got to share you women that God is having a lot of fun through you today, and it has blessed all of us with those three songs. I mean, that's got to be 4 songs, and we were up on our feet all 4 times. That's got to be a Seaside record here. It's, you know, there's spirit in the house. They would walk away. I don't know what Christian said today, but I sure feel good, you know, which is just fine. You know, it's the feeling where it happens. Anyway, it's a joy, absolutely joy. And so, hey, together we have created Seaside. You know, what's happening here is the result of our collective consciousness. You've called in Rebecca and this band and her wonderful friends, and it is your consciousness that has moved Seaside in a powerful direction of being a light of joy. You know, taking the message of celebration is the difference maker in the midst of adversity and challenges, whether it's personally or in our country or on the planet. You know, music is a world within itself, a language we all understand. There's equal opportunity for all of us to sing and dance and clap our hands. I mean, that is how it is love that makes the difference. And by giving in this moment to support God's work that is showing up in your life as Seaside, what you do is you continue to perpetuate and gift Seaside to the unfoldment of future generations that are forthcoming. By this action, this day, in this moment, for 30 years we have been standing here and doing this, and this moment has been passed on by those who back in 1988 had an idea called Seaside that called us all to be here. It's this moment. That's how profound it is. And big or small, it is collectively in our giving that is the difference maker. And we are the activity that God is having in this moment. So I invite you to look within your heart. I've got it in my coat, actually. But to find your abundant gift that you feel like sharing this day, this moment, I want to say thank you to those. Make sure there's none left in there. Oh, there is. How do you like that? For those that mail in your contributions when you can't be here, it's a big difference. For those who have practiced the auto tithe and said, you know what? Count me in. I'm going to give it all at once for the year, or I'm going to give it out regularly once a month or once a week. But you know what? Going into this year, this is what you can depend on for me. And I got to tell you, this is what served this community for the last year and a half. So those who practice the auto tithe, thank you. Difference maker. Those who mail it in, difference maker. Those who hit Venmo or Breeze or whatever is on your screen, thank you. It makes a difference. For those in this moment that give from the depths of their being, thank you. You know, this is a moment of true gratitude and appreciation. And so together we are standing at this moment. We have come through an amazing time because of the light and the celebration and love. So with that, I want to invite our ushers to come forward. I want to say thank you for this wonderful crew that stands at the door and welcomes you in as if it's their party and it's their home week after week. And so I'm going to share a prayer of gratitude. with the most generous of spiritual communities. For this is a rich moment. It is a blessed moment. It is a moment where the grace of God expresses through each and every one of us. We become, as Ernest Holmes was saying, all the universe that is within. We tap into things that have never been heard or felt like Stevie Wonder, for there is only one consciousness. We all have the ability to tap in. It's just different how we bring it forth. So in this abundant, rich, prosperous moment, I become that conduit and the activity of that affluent flow of spirit as I share that which has blessed my life, and I keep it in that blessing flow, and it moves forth into the world, bringing the good to all it touches. Thank you, Father, Mother, God, for this opportunity to be the abundant activity of spirit. And so it is. Amen. And together, let us say this affirmation of abundance, which is, Spirit continues to bless my world. Gratefully, I live as the giving expression of spirit, opening the floodgates of the affluent flow of greater good as my life now. I hope we didn't get bumped off. Seaside, just going wild today. You got John on the guitar, you got Bob on the saxophone, you got Harley on the bass, you got Jerry on those skins, and then you have got Max on the Paul Lloyd Warner piano and tearing up his own keyboards. Thank you guys so much. It's just powerful stuff. And so as I stand before this bounty, I can feel the love outpouring, for truly it is a representation of the emerging consciousness of greater good and a sense of grace and abundance that is living within the lives and the expression of the family here at Seaside. For truly I know each and every one of the givers are blessed by a deep sense of security and a peace that comes with knowing that the source is infinite and that it's truly inexhaustible, and as it moves, it heals and transforms in all areas. We give in one place and find all of it as God expressing in our life, so every aspect is divine. It's given in love, it is received in love, it is handled with good stewardship, and it's put back into the world, bringing your love and blessing and grace to everyone it touches. Thank you, Father, Mother, God, for this moment of action, and so it is. Amen. All right. You guys, this is Robert Furby. He is one of your board members here at Seaside. Also heads up the usher greeting at the first service, but I know the second service would like some extra people to play at the door with them so they could talk to Jackie, Sonny, Mike, Tracy. If you want to be at the door and greet people coming in, it's like, you know, it's your party. It's your fun. So talk to one of these. We could use your joy and support at the door. Okay, you're welcome. Thank you, Robert. Some of these board members don't like being up in public. It's beyond their comfort zone. And speaking, Rebecca and Carissa and Whitney, you guys just killed it today. It was absolutely amazing. You know, we have just taken it up another notch that next week the only thing we can do is you're dropping all your guest singers and guitar player and you're going solo with Billie Holiday, right? Woo, man, we're going soul and deep. And so, watch, if you got Hulu, watch Billie Holiday versus the U.S. or something. United States, for I haven't seen it yet, but I'm going to watch it this week. So if you want to know where I'm going to get my material, I'm giving it up. Anyway, Debbie, thank you for your support today. It's a joy. Maggie, for stepping up in that practitioner consciousness, representing our practitioners. And our beautiful flowers today, talking about practitioners. We had a beloved practitioner at Seaside. Kathy Paulson became a practitioner in 02, which means she was here in the 90s. She made her transition. We held her memorial service on Friday, and so the flowers are from her family. And I got to let you know that Kathy Paulson was as beautiful as these flowers. She was always immaculate, perfect, and just a composed individual of the expression of spirit. So we've got an ambassador who's gone before us. But those that are making things possible today in the sound booth is Ed. Thank you very much. Showing our PowerPoint is Marv. On the camera, one is Tim. Two is Edwin. Three is Mac. And putting all their film together live, I trust we didn't get kicked off today, but we are licensed. We told you that last week. We're licensed to perform and stream. So, but anyway, we have Steve in there and maybe Patrick in there and Tom. So never know who's behind that wall. But it takes a lot to share it with you guys at home. We know that you're there. You hold a high place in our hearts. You're part of the family for sure. So keep communicating with us. We love you. And you're in our prayers. And speaking of prayers, our practitioners are praying. We got Carolyn holding the light in our prayer center today. So go, if you want prayer, put it in the prayer box and or speak with, get a live prayer from a practitioner. Or if you're at home, you can always go live. So lots going on at Seaside, so take a look at the website. One of the big things we're pushing, as you heard Reverend Debbie say, is this party on September 19th. So if you want to help be part of the team that puts it on, there's sign-ups at the Seaside Sisters. Put volunteer Seaside Sister Service Center. Summer of Service is going on. And also what's big is James Von Prague's coming in October 1st, but next Sunday after the second service, we're having our first team meeting of volunteers. And Kay, you want to stand up? They can, if you're interested in volunteering, next Sunday, August 1st, Kay and I are going to meet with all of the volunteers who want to help put this October 1st event on. It's going to be big and exciting and dynamic. So, but anyway, there's a lot going on at Seaside. Our youth program is growing. Always could use individuals who would give us an hour a month. You know, I'm going to start talking about that every week, I think. Our children are really important. It's going to take our whole community to get that program rocking. So I'm going to, week after week, say, hey, can you give an hour? And we're going to have a table. You can sign up and be part of that. But what I'm going to do right now is pray. See, the whole morning is about moving to this point of prayer. You know, the music is incredible. The words are all right. But all of it is about shifting consciousness, the laughter, the tears. It's about becoming more available. As we talked about, waiting open-endedly is a radical and amazing opportunity to move beyond our level of imagining. You know, so we can just absolutely trust the good that God has in store, that our life is sculpted from love rather than fear. And so this is the moment. This is the moment that I choose to let it all go and feel that love that a spirit singing to us always. That love, that life, that joy, that expression, it has all been given, that consciousness that a Stevie Wonder tapped into that nobody had ever heard before, sounds that all of a sudden there was equipment to bring forth these experience, internal experience to share with the world. That same consciousness that a Whitney Houston tapped into, the consciousness that a Gandhi tapped into, that is our consciousness in which we live and move and have our being in. As Ernest said, all of the universe is within. And so I go there right now. I feel it. I sense it. I choose to come from that place, from that higher ground, that greater knowing, that from a language that we all know. It's a vibration. It's a sense. It's a light, it is love, it is a joy, it is a celebration of the infinite potential and possibilities, the positivity that is ever available. And so as I allow myself to feel and to move in that infinite sea of God's love and good healing happens. Not because I'm telling Spirit what to do, but because I have become available. I am waiting. I am lifted up on eagle's wings. I am lifted. The dolphins fly. The parrots live on the sea. The trees and the ocean get up and fly away. You know, all things are possible. And so as I tune into being available, I wait upon the Spirit. I find that I am renewed with a new strength. Healing happens. So if there's anyone here today that is experiencing any constraint, any challenge, any constriction, any dis-ease going on in the body or a world of affairs, lift it into this space, into this light, into this music, into this celebration, into this feel-good moment, and not need to tell the infinite intelligence what to do. It only makes Spirit laugh. Just lift it and let it go. And it's in this moment healing happens. I have become available for that which is beyond my imagining, that is beyond my thinking realm. I no longer am clinging to the results I want. I become available to the God emergence in a greater way that brings the abundance, that brings the love, that brings the perfect healing and transformation. My world is uplifted, and I keep trying until I reach that higher ground. I keep trying again, born again, start again. I reach higher ground, and still I reach higher. I keep finding God's hand out. I take hold. I feel the peace, the security, the love, the knowingness, the trust, the ability to let go, knowing my time and my space is mine to express myself, to experience Spirit as me, as you. So with gratitude, I know every prayer request has been brought forth to our prayer request is now answered. Practitioners who speak today in the prayer rooms or here speak the truth and healing happens. That Seaside is uplifted, it is growing, it is merging. We are coming through and emerging in a new time and a new light coming out of that tunnel that Reverend Debbie spoke about and found that there is light. And it's exciting and it is new and it is vibrant and we're available and willing to be new. I celebrate. I say thank you. Thank you for the words. Thank you for the thoughts. It's in the sense of grace and gratitude that I'm able to let go and surrender. For it's not my way, but God's way that is coming here that I celebrate and I dance and I clap and I sing and I express and I let go. Allow Spirit to have its way. And so it is. Amen.
There was a time in my life I thought I had to do it all for myself. God was sufficient. I didn't know the love of God was in hand. But now I can say, if you are discouraged, struggling just to make it through another day, you've got to let go. Yeah. And this is what you have to say.
I release and I let go. Let the Spirit run my life.
And my
heart is open wide.
Yes, I'm only here for God. No more struggle, no more strife. With my faith I see the light. I am free in the Spirit. Yes, I'm only God, said I release and I let go. I let the Spirit run my life, and my heart is open wide. Yes, I'm only here for God. No more struggle, no more strife. With my faith, I see the light. I am free in the Spirit. Yes, I'm only here for God.
Seaside, sing it from your heart. Come on.
celebration is I move in the rhythm with the key of life. Together.
I move in the rhythm with the key of life.
Touch your heart and say that again.
I move in the rhythm with the key of life.
One more time. Feel it.
I move in the rhythm with the key of life.
And our song of grace.
I'm living in love. I'm living in peace. I'm living my life for what I believe. Through joys and through fears, in this world I walk, God's grace shines on me and it shines on us all. We are living in grace. We are living in grace. We are living in grace. We're living in love. We're living in peace. United we stand as one family. We honor all truth as together we walk. God's grace moves through me and it moves through us all. We are living in grace. We are living in grace. We are living in grace. We are living in grace.
Yeah. Have a fantastic week, Seaside.
Thank you.